Namaste. I'm Dzangko. Welcome to Walking and Talking and Meditating and Creating Change. So, whatever you're doing today, and I hope that every day you take a little bit of time to get a walk in or get some cardio in. Always, I would say yoga, stretching, moving. These are the things you have to do. Eat some good food. Drink some water that is actually good for you. It's there. You have to find it. Sometimes you have to pay for it. It costs. But it's there. So the point I'm making. Times are changing. And we've got to change, and I think we've got to prepare. I don't know what we're preparing for. We've been told different things, depending on what book you read, what translation, and who's reading it. All I know is right now, I think it's more important than ever that we lose everything that has self-destructive potential. We lose our behaviors. How about that? I'll change so you can see the clouds. That looks pretty cool, just like that. Well, either way, I can't do that. I have to walk. So we know that right now there are certain energies within our bodies, your chakras, you've got meridian points. It's been studied about for thousands of years, Chinese, in India. So the knowledge of the human body and how it operates, those fine little things, little points, they're there. The understanding is not all there, but it's there. It's available. So each person has a responsibility to figure out how to take care of your body. This is the one we were issued. This is mine. I have to, you know, it's funny because, boy, we can be Facebook queens, can't we? It's easy to be a Facebook queen. But we have to get out and actually do these things because I know firsthand, I am a breast cancer survivor. Stage 3, multiple tumors, invasive, very bad. And I survived. I wasn't expected to survive, but I survived. And I know that these things, more and more that we learn about our bodies and what we can do to work with the medical profession, our opportunities become limitless. So, take responsibility for your own body. I can go, you know, on tangents. I'm trying to stay focused. But we have to take responsibility for our body. What we eat, what we drink, what we think. Everything that we put in this, it's called a temple. Not just in the Bible, you know, King James. So you've got all of these religions coming together throughout planet Earth. All of us, if we're here and in human form, need a body to enjoy this. So take care of your body, right? That's the bottom line. You have to take care of your body. And you have to educate yourself. There's a lot of money being made off of our illnesses, the diseases. We have truly, kept the system going, and we should be proud of ourselves. But, it's time to maybe reclaim some of our power. And the power that we have lies within our ability to take control and to make changes. When you realize that you are powerful, as a woman, as a gentle man, when you realize you have this power, and when you're trying to do things that are good, you've got the whole universe on your side. So there's nothing to fear. You have to let fear go, because the universe can use everything you do. If you do it from a place of love, if you do it with the heart space felt desire to want to connect, and for the betterment of not just yourself, but when you take care of yourself, you help us all. So each person that comes into this awakening, enlightenment, whatever you want to call it, doesn't really matter. Don't care. But once you realize you are changed, you feel different, you look at your food differently, you look at your children differently, you look at yourself differently, you look at your mate differently, and if you're single, you begin to even look at being single differently. And you see, again, part of this is not just yoga. This is, I would presume, every understanding as it comes together. We see that, I'm looking around to make sure I don't trip on anything. We've had a lot of wind blowing, so we have tree limbs fall down. So we come together, and now is, I believe, and I'm people have been saying this for thousands of years, but it feels so close. It feels we are on the cusp. Now, we know, coming in December, go check with NASA. Go look on the government websites. And for, for the people that are, government, anti-government, you don't believe what they say. I feel ya. But I don't have a telescope that will reach into that part of space. So I have to at least take the technology that's available to us, like that. Mm-hmm. I could have fallen. Yeah. That was an acorn. That wasn't a limb. So, that would have been funny. Not really. I wasn't that close. But my point is, you have to watch. Even when I'm talking, I have to be aware of what's going on. The whole planet is wilderness. I mean, we have, when you're driving, it's a jungle. You can't tell me that's not a jungle. You have to pay attention to what you're doing when you're driving. When you're walking, I urge us all to pay attention, because you can get yourself hurt, or you can hurt someone else if you're driving and you're not paying attention, and let's say you hit a pedestrian or a biker. So you have to be in the now. Yeah, I know. Have we heard that enough? Oh, we might be able to see a friend. There's, okay, sidebar. We have some beautiful, beautifully rich, vibrant birds in these here parts. So there was a cardinal, And I was trying to see if we could get him on camera, but I think not. So, well, it was worth trying though. Really, there, and because it's so green out right now, everything, it just stands out so much. So, all right, so pretty much everybody knows by now, if you don't take care of your body, you're sick, you're miserable, you're depressed. Whew. I mean, seriously, exercise, say it again, it really will modify your brain patterns, increase oxygen that goes throughout your whole body, which means your whole body feels better when you exercise. So it's a reward. You know, anybody that does it just to maintain physical attractiveness, you still get the benefits, no doubt. But the point, your body is really an amazing tool. And when you do good things for it and to it, it rewards you. So, hooray. So I think everybody, planet-wise, understands that obesity is an epidemic. Many of the diseases that we now battle and lose. And we're not just battling, we're losing. Cancer, diabetes. I didn't bring my book, but you know, the list is pretty long. So taking care of your body and doing your part, starting with our children, because you have to teach them in a way that they understand. And it's fun because, let me tell you, being out in nature, it is fun. So, you have to find ways to let them explore and find things that work for them. So that they have exercise as a tool. It is, again, it's part of that whole plan. So, moving on. You know, I'm going to always talk about yoga. I'm going to always talk against food having chemicals that are toxic. I'm going to. And I hope that there's many, many more people in the yoga community, in the health community, in the holistic community. Ooh, I got an itch, bug. But that begin using their voices. And it is important. This is like code blue. We've got to get this information out. And again, our bodies need to be detoxed. We need to get some chemicals out. And there's ways to do this. I probably part two. Maybe by then I'll have some links up and we'll go from there. But a detox would be nice right now. So, you know, there's a roadmap. There's some things that the masses in the healing community probably would suggest, you know, would be good things to do. Your religious communities would, you know, say there are things, you know, to do, places to go, people to see, and love to exchange. So now is the time to let go of everything that no longer works. If it doesn't work, it's got to go. And it's got to go in a loving way. We've got to move from judgment to acceptance and from hate to love. We've lived in this fear, darkened, shadowed, you know, cave for so long. And it is time that we stepped out. We were brave. You got to be brave. Accept responsibility. And let's move. Let's move forward. Let's prepare our bodies. Let's begin working on that healing grid. Now, the healing grid, that was the part that got, I don't know, lost in Cyberville somewhere. It's somewhere, but I can't find it. So, technology, I love it. So, but it's time that the healing grid, love, the sooner that we have people, of course, around the planet doing that and uniting in their conscious intentions, that's important. We need to have the same intention. There's a good chance that we do have the power within to protect our planet and our people from what's about to come. I don't know. I don't know how it will go down. Again, you know, if you believe in the Bible says no man shall know. It also, you know, talks about the things leading up through tribulation. It talks about, you know, the second coming. And people, you know, will, one community calls it ascend. One community may call it rapture. What do you call it? There's a lot of names, you know. It's a big planet. But I want us to be ready. I want to be ready, but I want you to be ready. And nobody really knows. You know, we're not saying that we do. But based upon, if you do, you know, go do your research. I don't have time here. The Mayan, the Aztecs, research the cultures, research the crop circles, start putting it all together. Meditate, pray, and see what you come up with. See what your spirit, your guide, your angels say. All right, this is the end of part one.